Hari Om friends, welcome once again to my Sanatan Duniya channel, your spiritual home. In this video, I shall be giving my commentary upon verses 44 to 55 of the 11th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. For those of you who have not yet watched the commentaries on the previous verses of the Gita, I suggest you go ahead and watch these videos before proceeding further with this video. These videos are available in the playlist titled Bhagavad Gita Commentary, all 18 chapters. Before I go ahead and give the commentary upon these verses of the 11th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, I have a small request to make. If you have not already subscribed to my channel, then I suggest you do so that you may be updated about forthcoming videos uploaded to this channel. So let's move on. The 44th to 46th slokas of the 11th chapter of the Gita are as follows. You are the Supreme Lord to be worshipped by every living being. Thus I fall down to offer you my respects and ask your mercy. Please tolerate the wrongs that I may have done to you and bear with me as a father with his son, or a friend with his friend, or a lover with his beloved. After seeing this universal form which I have never seen before, I am gladdened, but at the same time my mind is disturbed with fear. Therefore, please bestow your grace upon me and reveal again your form as the personality of Godhead, O Lord of Lords, O abode of the universe. O universal Lord, I wish to see you in your forearm form, with helmeted head and with club, wheel, conch and lotus flower in your hands. I long to see you in that form. The commentary of the mentioned three slokas is as follows. The Vishwaroopa shown by the Lord to Arjuna represents the total universal mind of creation, or the mind of God. After beholding this great spectacle, Arjuna realized that Lord Krishna was not just a dear friend of his, but rather the Supreme Lord of the creation. That is why he says here that Lord Krishna is to be worshipped by every living being. All living creatures are, consciously or unconsciously, in search of that Supreme Power who can give unconditional love, acceptance and protection to them. Lord Krishna revealed through the Vishwaroopa that he is the Paramatma or God of the entire creation. Irrespective of which form we worship, we are ultimately worshipping the one Paramatma only. This has already been confirmed by Lord Krishna in the 9th chapter, where the Lord said that those who worship other deities with faith in their heart worship him, the Paramatma, alone. Hence, Arjuna says that Lord Krishna is the Paramatma who is to be worshipped by every living entity. Now suppose if we were to meet the Lord in person, what would be the first thing we would do out of love for the Lord? Most of us, if not all of us, would fall at the feet of the Lord to offer our respects and ask for his mercy. This was what Arjuna did when he realized that Lord Krishna is Sakshat Paramatma. Further, Arjuna is also making the most of this opportunity by asking Krishna Paramatma to please tolerate all the wrongs that he might have done inadvertently. All of us are imperfect outwardly and all of us commit mistakes. Hence, asking for forgiveness from the Lord is natural, as if the Lord does not forgive us and tolerate our wrongdoings, then who else will? This Vishwaroopa Darshan which Lord Krishna had given to Arjuna was too majestic and glorious for Arjuna to behold for a long time. Therefore, as soon as Arjuna spent some time appreciating and glorifying the Vishwaroopa, he pleaded with Lord Krishna to reveal his four-armed Vishnu form, which is comparatively more easier to behold and less glaring and overwhelming. This request by Arjuna to Lord Krishna indicates that Arjuna by then had recognized Lord Krishna to be an avatar of Lord Vishnu. In fact, so great is Lord Krishna that many people believe that Lord Vishnu is the avatar of Lord Krishna and that Lord Krishna is the source of millions of Lord Vishnus present in the different universes of the creation. Boliye Shri Krishna Bhagwan ki Jai. Now I shall move on to verses 47 to 51. The 47th to 51st verses of the 11th chapter of the Gita are as follows. The Blessed Lord said, My dear Arjuna, happily do I show you this universal form within the material world by my internal potency. No one before you has ever seen this unlimited and glaring effulgent form. O best of the Kuru warriors, no one before you has ever seen this universal form of mine. For neither by studying the Vedas, nor by performing sacrifices, nor by charities or similar activities can I be seen in this form. Only you have seen this. Your mind has been perturbed upon seeing this horrible feature of mine. Now let it be finished. My devotee, be free from all disturbance. With a peaceful mind, you can now see the form you desire. Sanjaya said to Dhritarashtra, the Supreme Personality of Godhead Krishna, while speaking thus to Arjuna, displayed his real four-armed form and last he showed him his two-armed form, thus encouraging the fearful Arjuna. When Arjuna thus saw Krishna in his original form, he said, seeing this human-like form so very beautiful, my mind is now pacified and I am restored to my original nature. The commentary of the mentioned five slokas is as follows. Just see how fortunate Arjuna is. Also, let us appreciate what tremendous amount of good karma Arjuna must have done over many births to be able to get the vision of this divine form of the Krishna Paramatma. So glorious is this darshan done by Arjuna that the Lord is saying that nobody before this has ever seen this form of Lord Krishna. Indeed, miracles happen only to the fortunate few. Not everybody can behold a miracle, especially like the way Arjuna has done here. Actually, Lord Vishnu or Lord Krishna has shown his four-armed Vishnu form many times before to many devotees who are regular in their sadhana and who long to be one with the Lord. But nobody except Arjuna has ever beheld his complete Vishwaroopa form. This Vishwaroopa form has not been beheld even by exalted devotees of the Lord like Prahlad or Dhruv. Prahlad, Dhruv and certain other devotees have only seen the four-armed form of Lord Vishnu and not the colossal Vishwaroopa form. Beholding the four-armed form of Lord Vishnu itself is a very great achievement. So what to speak of beholding the Vishwaroopa form? Let us appreciate the goodness and greatness of Arjuna. So how can one become eligible to get darshan of the Lord's Vishwaroopa form? The Lord answers this question by saying that this Vishwaroopa form cannot be beheld by studying scriptures, or performing sacrifices, or performing charities, or other such good and pious deeds. These activities can help one to obtain other blessings and entitlements, but not the Vishwaroopa darshan. After seeing Arjuna frightened by the Vishwaroopa, and after Arjuna had requested the Lord to show him his four-armed form, the Lord withdrew the terrifying Vishwaroopa form and then revealed his four-armed Vishnu form and then his two-armed normal Krishna form. The Lord always has his devotees' welfare in mind. If any devotee of the Lord is uneasy with any grand vision or blessing, then for the welfare of that devotee, he may even withdraw or simplify that boon or blessing. After seeing a grand form which is so effulgent, when we return to our normalcy, we would naturally feel relieved and more comfortable. Same was the case here with Arjuna, who returned to normalcy after the Vishwaroopa was withdrawn by the Lord. Now I shall move on to verses 52 to 55. The 52nd to 55th verses of the 11th chapter of the Gita are as follows. The Blessed Lord said, "My dear Arjuna, the form which you are now seeing is very difficult to behold. Even the demigods are ever seeking the opportunity to see this form which is so dear. The form which you are seeing with your transcendental eyes cannot be understood simply by studying the Vedas, nor by undergoing serious penances, nor by charity, nor by worship. It is not by these means that one can see me as I am. My dear Arjuna, only by undivided devotional service can I be understood as I am standing before you and can thus be seen directly. Only in this way can you enter into the mysteries of my understanding. My dear Arjuna, one who is engaged in my pure devotional service, free from the contaminations of previous activities and from mental speculation, who is friendly to every living entity, certainly comes to me." The commentary of the mentioned four slokas is as follows. In the first two of the above mentioned four verses, the Lord is reiterating two points. One, this Vishwaroopa is very difficult to behold, and even the demigods are eager to see this form of the Lord. And two, this Vishwaroopa cannot be beheld by austerity, sacrifices, charities, or even by normal worship. Then the question arises, is it even possible for a devotee to behold this form of the Lord? And if so, then how? The Lord answers this question by saying that it is only by undivided devotional service that he can be seen as he is. Even among the devotees of God, there are different grades of devotees. Most people of this world believe in some god or the other and consider themselves to be pious and good devotees of their deity. However, just being good and occasionally worshipping the Lord, that too for the fulfillment of their own selfish desires, is not going to give much spiritual benefit or progress. In order to obtain a boon or blessing the way Arjuna did, or the way other exalted devotees of Lord Vishnu like Prahlad and Dhruv had done, one needs to be devoted to the Lord without any selfish motive or desire. For example, if a person claims to be a devotee of Lord Krishna and just says a meek 2-minute prayer every day and visits a temple of the Lord only because some astrologer had asked him to strengthen some planet in his birth chart, or out of desire to win a lottery or gain a promotion or job or house or some other material benefit, then this does not qualify as devotional service. Devotional service refers to all those activities which are done with love and devotion to God and in order to please the Lord. Also, the worship or deeds should be free from desire for any selfish material gain. In other words, the worship or actions should be done only to please the Lord and not to please his wife or children or to gain some material wealth or benefit. Some of the best examples of unselfish and pure devotional service to the Lord are those rendered by pure devotees like Prahlad, Dhruv, Draupadi, Sudama, Meera, etc. Only if our devotion can be even 0.1% of their love and devotion can we be called pure devotees. Otherwise, we are just worldly and materialistic people, and we only love money and not God. If we too can render unselfish and pure devotion to the Lord, then we too can see Him face to face, or even realize the truth of the Supreme Self that Bhagawan represents. Finally, in the last sloka of this chapter, Bhagawan is stating the requirement on the part of the devotee to attain self-realization or love for God. If a devotee wishes to attain self-realization or knowledge and become an exalted devotee like Prahlad and others, that he or she must render unselfish and unmotivated devotional service to the Lord and also feel the Lord's presence in every living entity. If one can feel the presence of the Lord in all living entities, then it is obvious that he or she will be friendly to them as well. So if we wish to please the Lord, then we should take to chanting the Lord's names, meditation, selfless service, attending satsangs and dedicating all our activities and life to God. This way we will purify our existence and purify the world too. And if we can live like this all our lives, then going back to God at the end of our lives is guaranteed. So friends, here ends the commentary on the 44th to 55th verses of the 11th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. And with this we come to the end of the 11th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita. Stay tuned for more commentaries on the following verses of the Gita and keep checking this channel for updates to this playlist titled Bhagavad Gita Commentary All 18 Chapters, and also do watch the other videos available in this channel so that you can enhance your knowledge of the eternal religion or Sanatan Dharma. And in case you have not already subscribed to my channel, then I suggest you do so, so that you may be updated about forthcoming videos uploaded to this channel. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great time ahead. Hari Om.